To chase or not to chase, that is the question. As a young man trying to attract interest from the opposite sex, I made a lot of mistakes. The biggest being coming on too strong. I'd spy the object of my affection and then chase, finding every opportunity to be in front of them, and frankly, chasing them away. Many of us do exactly this with our prospects. We identify someone and then immediately spruik our message. All about us. We think we're adding value by sending them stuff, filling their inboxes. So rather than being an invited guest, we become an unwanted pest. Delete, delete, delete. So stop the chase. Think back to how you started friendships and intimate relationships. There was an element of curiosity, wanting to find out more about the other person, slow and steady. You probably didn't appreciate someone dumping their whole life history on you from the word go. Business is no different. The purpose of prospecting is to establish three things. One, do they have a problem? Two, do they accept that they have it? And three, do they feel they need to address it? You want to be in a position where your prospects are curious and show interest in you. What you can do for them, where they want to know more. Which means you need to give them the space and ultimately persuade themselves to take the next step and form a relationship. Don't push. Have them come towards you. And the best way to do that is to be curious about them. Be interested, not interesting. Always remember, you have 2 years and 1 month. Use them in that proportion. And finally, give up control. It's up to your prospects whether they want to continue the conversation or not, have a meeting or not. So be at peace with no. If you'd like to improve your sales ability, talk to us about our sell, prospect, and market programs. We can work with you individually or as part of our group masterclasses. More details are at revealedresources.com. Till next time, this is Rashid Kotwal.